the splurge amounts, please.
SMC Media Makers is a student-operated production house dedicated to learning, training, and inspiring future media makers through hands-on experience, critical thinking, and high-level coordination, ultimately reflecting the collaborative diversity of our state. Our goal is to allow students and educators to work together alongside industry representatives to create a pathway that will allow for them to get their foot in the door and into the industry.
It's very short, as you can see, and simple and straight to the point. And I guess today here I wasn't really necessarily kind of to showcase or talk about SMC Media Makers as opposed to coming here to really engage the members that have come here today and to talk with you all and ask you the question of how can we engage you? How can we engage each other? How can we come together and come up with ways to educate and ways to get people the technical know-how and the soft skills that are needed to really prevail as individuals and to really come together as a community to enter into all the fields that people have the respect and interest in. And I was very much happy when the previous speakers came on and shared all the wonderful programs that they've went through or their experiences that they have had. And I feel like if there's all these things out there, why do I know about it? Why do I know? Like, for real. If I'm a college student, or if I'm formerly incarcerated, if I'm formerly whatever, if I'm just living, how is it that I don't already know this information? And so it's how do you get this relevance out there? And that's what I'm hoping Keys will do. And so I guess it goes back to the question I asked, which was, how can I engage you? And is there anyone who would be willing to answer that?
We got a.
Well, I mean, you're doing it. You demonstrate. I've seen you in action. You're fearless. You're courageous. You're inquisitive, and you're professional, and you're respectful. And I think all of those qualities resonate and help build the reputation and the identity. I think that. One you are trying to promote, and I think one that you care about. So I think the fact that you are unafraid to ask questions, to ask the right questions, and to connect with people, and not presume any knowledge, I think is a quality that will take you far. Following up with everyone you meet, and keeping them informed of your progress and reminding them that you remember what they told you and what value it had to your path, to your progress, I think reinforces to people you meet that you listen and that you value, and you're not just asking a question to ask a question, that you truly are taking it in, that you're testing it, you're experimenting, and that you're growing, and that you want more. Don't be afraid to ask for more, and to even ask, give a price. You know, if you're working on a project and you need a certain amount of money to get you to the next phase, can you help me, or who do you know? You can't be afraid to ask those questions. You will get results when you do.
Well, wonderful, thank you.
I was going to say what he said, because I've seen you in action as well, but maybe be more specific about engage generally in what? What are you asking? Mm-hmm. And then because I was saying, well, where would I start? Like, yes, the answer is I would love to be help you, engage you, but what are you looking for? What are you asking for?
Well, to answer that question, thank you for asking that actually. To answer your question on how we all can engage one another, what I've designed really and what I've also seen alongside our professors, alongside my president, is creating sort of like an incubator program of sorts that will allow for people within the industry, students and professors to come together and to design a program. And it's really empowering everybody. There's no input not put out. And I feel like one of the missing links or missing connections to empowering students or empowering entrepreneurs is giving them a voice. If they don't have a voice or a seat at the table to where they're able to voice, you know, what experiences they've had in not getting the success they needed, not getting the resource they needed, then they need to be able to voice that. And they need to be able to be addressed from people who have different perspectives, people who are in the industry, as well as people who are not in the industry, as well as educators, because they're really the bridge to getting and educating people into the actual workforce. And so it's taking people from these three respective groups, students who are trying to learn, educators who are there to teach, who are the bridge, and the industry people who are looking to hire. And it's putting them together to design programs, to design classrooms that give the exposure, the experience, the technical know-how, and the soft skills that are necessary and needed to actually be successful. And so that's how I would ask for people to engage. And I feel that we've been taking all the right steps so far, and I feel that we've sort of reached that point, kind of like how Morel earlier was talking about how when he made his film, that like, you know, what can you do right now if you can't actually make the film, we'll make a trailer. So
can we make the program? No.
Do we have the funds? That would be nice, but no, we don't. So start simple, keep it small. And so that's why I say incubator. I'm not sure how much I'm allowed to disclose about that, so I'm gonna do. But it's definitely a program that I envision is scalable. It's going from a realistic standpoint, and it's a program that does not assume. It does not assume anything. It's a program that's very poignant on the disclosure and the sharing of information that's needed to build the proper step-by-step program. And I guess I hope that answers your question. That would be how I would engage, and how I'd ask you to engage me as well. Yes.
Well, first of all, I'm not your president, I'm your friend, Shoni. Thank you very much. I'm so proud of you. I met Shoni a year ago on SMC's campus when I first decided to go from film into television, because I'm like, there's something more. They're telling us one thing, but there's all these other things happening, and I can't be blind anymore. And so I was blessed enough to be an experience with direct mentors, and they advised me to develop this club the opposite way it's been run, which is a cycle of hierarchy. And so this semester I tried something new. I tried to find someone in our midst with the same vision that I had originally, someone I knew could carry the torch with even more of a brighter light. And Shoni has been the perfect guy for the job. From day one, he's been asking, what can I do? And where can I go, and who can I meet? And just that engagement alone of being inquisitive is enough to really catch people's attention and help them understand that you're genuine enough to do the job and to care enough to get their needs fulfilled as well. Because as my mentors say, the three C's, communication, commitment, and co-creation. Co-creation is the engagement that allows us to actually rise together. And from the beautiful work we saw earlier, it's clear to see that together we are stronger. It takes human revolution of your own kind and really embracing yourself in order to tell these stories. And Shoni's done an impeccable job of doing that. And yeah.
Question? Sir?
How do you get such a low risk, bro?
What did he say?
Get such a glorious bro. It's a very good question. It's a, that's the next film right there. Stay tuned.
I would say one thing. If I look at all of that,